In this video, I'm going to give you 13 basic marketing techniques coming right up. Now, this is John Lee. If it's the first time you come across my channel and you love to learn how to market your business, become a master at marketing, then make sure you hit the subscribe button, turn on bell notifications so you don't miss out on all the new content that I'll be creating. So the first thing that you really want to do when it comes to mastering the marketing basics is to optimize your content. What do I mean by this? So for example, a lot of you follow me or watch my videos because it's all about growing businesses or starting business. So you really want to optimize your content in such a way that you, instead of having to think about all these different things to do, like right now I have one set, I have one camera, I've got a few lights, and then I'm optimizing the way I'm filming my content, but I'm also getting the message straight. So I'll create one video and then I'll create another video around that. So you really start to optimize that. So it's getting real clear, and the laser target your message, the more it penetrates. Okay, number two, if you really want to start marketing basics, is to make sure that you are advertising online. So what things could you do? You could use Facebook advertising. You can use YouTube ads. So maybe some of you have seen my YouTube videos where I put an ad in front of a video, so you see my video first. You can use TikTok. You can use Snapchat. You can, Snapchat, you can still actually advertise on the platform. You got LinkedIn. So there are lots of paid ways. I spend millions of dollars testing a lot of this stuff out on marketing. And the idea when it comes to spending money online is to make sure that you, whatever you spend, you're making back more, or you're at least breaking even, and then you make money through what we call a LTV, the lifetime value. Third thing you gotta do, especially when it comes to marketing basics, is make sure you have some kind of call to action, because a lot of people, especially if you're spending money on marketing, a lot of people don't actually have a call to action. So a clear call to action would be, hey, if you'd love to learn more about business and marketing and making more passive income, hit the subscribe button and turn on bell notifications right now. So that would be a clear call to action. You've probably heard me say that throughout all my videos that I've actually put on YouTube, is always giving a clear call to action. The fourth thing you can do is you could actually write a blog. So a blog used to be a little bit old school, but still people are reading a lot of blogs. And in fact, one of the best ways to do it is to create a video. So let's say, for example, I'm creating this video right now, but what you can do is you can get that video transcribed and you can turn that into a blog post. Instead of you having to write the thing over again, best way to do it is to actually transcribe a video into a blog and then put that on there. And there's actually a really good website called rev.com. I'll leave a link below, but that will allow you to actually transcribe your videos really fast. Okay, number five of marketing basics is to publish a book. So as you can see back there, I have three books. I'm a published author, and each book talks about different things. So the Wealth Dragon Way talks about mindset. The Property Entrepreneur book talks about how to invest in real estate. And the Business Hack book talks about how do we use technology in today's industry to be able to earn more income. So if you are in a level where you think, you know what, I'm not sure what to do, just actually publish a book about it. Because when you publish a book about this, what'll happen is you'll start to get a lot more exposure. A lot of people start reading the book and they'll start passing it around to people, therefore growing your marketing organically. Okay, number six for marketing basics is to make sure you understand your competition. So if you don't understand your competition, there's a saying that says, if you don't know yourself and you don't know your enemy, when you're going to battle, you're gonna lose your battle. If you know yourself and you know your enemy, you'll have a 50% chance of winning. If you know yourself and you know your enemy, the battle is won before it is even fought. I've actually read that in a book called The Art of War by Sun Tzu. It's an amazing book about warfare, but it's really strategic for business. So it's how do we use that? And you have to understand your competition, because you gotta look at what they're doing and you gotta ask yourself, how can I do it better? How can I innovate and make it better? Okay, number seven is you can use Twitter and you can start tweeting. So the good thing about tweeting is it's regular. So, you know, if you're somebody who wants to let people know what you're doing like every hour or every couple of hours, a good thing, you can just keep tweeting things and it just keeps people updated. And the good thing about this is when you're tweeting, what you're doing is you're keeping people on top of mind. So when you're on top of people's minds, what starts to happen is they start to think more about you, and therefore you're able to get more business and drive more traffic to your business. Therefore, it's a very effective basic marketing strategy that you can use to always stay on top of mind. Okay, number eight on basic marketing strategies, one of my favorites, is to use email marketing campaigns. So if you've probably received a lot of emails from me in the past, when I'm not always sending emails out specifically about, for example, you know, once a week I'll have this kind of like a newsletter, but it's like a video letter that really says, hey, by the way, these are the videos I filmed this week, check it out. So, you know, I get a lot more people to, you know, look at my products, my services, I'm adding value. And the key thing here with when it comes to email campaigns, campaigns is to make sure that when you're sending emails out, you're not always selling things all the time. Like, what happens if people are trying to sell you things over and over and over again? You get annoyed. But guess what? If we add a bit of value first and we actually add value to people's lives, guess what's gonna happen? We're gonna get more and more people come to us and really say, oh, by the way, John, that thing that you taught me about, I got a lot of value from that. Do you have anything that I can buy? So that's the right way to do email campaigns. Okay, number nine, this basic strategy for marketing is using Facebook ads. So right now, a lot of people, what they're doing is they're making posts on Facebook and the only people who are seeing it are their friends. We don't want our friends to see it because our friends are not our buyers. So it's really important that we actually get our buyers to be able to see our products and services. The problem is, if they're not friends with you and they're your buyers, you won't show up in their newsfeed. That's why you have to use Facebook ads, and this is what we call dark posts. When you make a dark post or a Facebook ad post and it goes dark, no one can see the post apart from the people that you want to see that post, i.e. relevant laser targeting. Okay, number 10 for basic marketing techniques is to give things away for free. I give a lot of things away for free. I have hundreds of videos all across social media, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of them, if not thousands, that I've put up by just giving away content for free. So the whole idea of this is to make sure that whatever that you're giving away for free, make sure there's a sample of what it is that you do. For example, a lot of people watch my videos on YouTube and then they say, John, I'd love to learn more. So I do actually have a 3-day bootcamp. It's a social media and business bootcamp where I'm teaching people all about social media, about entrepreneurship. And guys, if you're interested, I'll leave a link below as well. And by giving things away free, you kind of give like a teaser away. And this is concept called content for free, implementation for a fee. So that's, again, it's another great way for you to be able to really market. It's a really good basic marketing technique. Okay, number 11, this one's classic, is to drop the price. So occasionally, or quite often, depending on how often you want to do this, or how, you know, frequently or infrequently you want to do this, you want to have promotions. Like, I always say that every single month you should always have a promotion, because promotions always drive sales. So one month there'll be promotion on this, the second month there'll be promotion on something else, the third month there'll be promotion on XYZ. So the whole key to this is to make sure that you, when you have your calendar, basic marketing technique is to make sure that you're putting in different campaigns for different months of the year. And so in, you know, month one you'll have this campaign, month two, and these can involve a lot of price drops. So maybe in a certain month they get this much discount off, or maybe in another month they get this much off. And you want to tie it towards some kind of celebration. Like if it's close to a celebration where, you know, maybe it's Christmas time, or where maybe it's like, and you see Alibaba do this really well. They do these big launches and they do like $1 billion in like an hour. It's because they're kind of piggybacking on a trend or some kind of event that's happening where everybody can relate to that justifies that price drop. Okay, number 12 for a basic marketing technique is to streamline your brand. So what I mean by this, so a lot of you go, well, John, like, which social media platform should I use? Should I use Facebook, Instagram, YouTube? Like which one should I use? The ones that you should use are the ones that are the easiest for you to, I guess, relate with. So for example, right now I film a lot of videos. So every day I put daily videos on my YouTube channel, and I'm just really talking about a lot of the concepts that people are asking me. So I'm kind of streamlining that. The way I'm doing that, I'm getting a lot of questions from people. In fact, if you would like to have me create a video on a specific topic, leave a comment below. I'll read through the comments and I'll see what suggestions you have, and then I'll start creating videos around that. But the whole idea of this is to make sure you're streamlining your brand. Okay, the last one, which is really, really important, is test campaigns. So test campaigns work where you are putting out little things to see if it actually converts. So for example, whenever I am starting a campaign, I'll put a $1,000 budget, I'll see how it converts, I'll see what the clicks are, how many people see it. And really important thing with this is when you are testing out your campaign, I mean, you might not have $1,000 to, you know, to test with. You might start with $20, right? So you might run $20 for a week. And if you're spending like $100, $120, $140, $200, whatever it is, look at what return you're getting. Is there a hint of conversion coming in, or is there not a hint of conversion coming in? You want to test it out, see how much interest there is. Like when I launched the books back then, you know, I put a free trial to say, hey, by the way, I've got, you know, my new books coming out. If you'd like to get the first couple of chapters, click here, and they click there to have a look, and bang, guess what happens? I start getting sales because people have tested it, and now it shows me a big demand, and now I'm able to offer more products and services. So I really hope you got a lot of value from this. If you got a lot of value from these 13 different steps to creating basic marketing techniques, then what I want you to do is hit the like button. And if you want to see more of my videos coming up, hit the subscribe button, turn on bell notifications, and leave a comment below to say done, or just say that you know say that you've watched this video. Because when you do all these interactions in my video, YouTube will show you more of my videos. So what I'm going to do, I'm also going to link some videos here and here, and also put a subscribe button up here as well. And again, if it's the first time you come across me, hit the subscribe button, turn on bell notifications. You don't miss out. I upload daily videos specifically on business, entrepreneurship, growing businesses, marketing, sales, and passive income creation. So I really hope you got a lot of value from this. Again, check out the other videos and the subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next videos. John Lee, the author of Business Hack. Bye for now.